views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly Neff. This hit show will illuminate your senses and empower you beyond your daily stressors and hardships. Renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly will captivate you with far-reaching topics and amazing guests as you wake to the greatest version of yourself. Learn to tap into your intuitions, think critically about our world, heal emotional and psychological wounds, and follow your passions to live your dreams. Each week, you'll learn how to navigate the global shift of consciousness and explore the deeper knowledge within. Welcome home. Now here's your host, Dr. Kelly Neff.
Hello, everyone. I am Dr. Kelly, and you are listening to Lucid Planet Radio on Transformation Talk Radio and WBLQ, 1230 AM, Rhode Island, Connecticut, and New York. Stay with us for the next hour, and let us help you experience inspiration, creativity, and knowledge. Because every Wednesday at 5 p.m. Eastern on Lucid Planet Radio, we will have some of the most gifted scientists, healers, artists, speakers, and authors helping you to discover the greatest version of yourself. You can find out more at thelucidplanet.com and listen to all of my show archives at lucidplanetradio.com. I have some really big news to start off the show, and I just want to say that I am thrilled to announce that Lucid Planet Radio has been picked up by the CRN Digital Talk Network, which is going to put us into over 11 million homes in the U.S. across networks in California, Nevada, Arizona, Pennsylvania, Delaware, Florida, North Carolina, and more. And we will also be streaming in over 90 countries and on the AHA in-car radio app via iTunes, Apple TV, and Roku. Wow, I'm so grateful. I'm so excited. If you're in these states and you've been thinking about maybe advertising with us, this would be a great time to jump on board. And I am happy to offer some wonderful introductory sponsorship rates that really won't be around for long. This is especially true of my home city of Denver, Colorado. We will be coming at you very soon. So you can find out more about all of this and how to get involved and become a sponsor or a partner of the show at thelucidplanet.com. And you can also email me at drkellyneff@gmail.com. So, wow. Awesome stuff. Today's show, we are really picking off where we left off from last week, and we are continuing this discussion of spirituality, psychedelics, creativity, art, and culture, and really how all of these are coming together to help us to shape our future. And to continue this discussion, I am really stoked today to welcome legendary visionary artist Chris Dyer of Chris Dyer's Positive Creations to the show. A little bit about Chris. He grew up in Lima, Peru, up to when he was 17, and then he moved to Canada to study art. And he is based in Montreal, where he works as a freelance artist. And Chris is probably best known for his amazing, colorful, detailed, psychedelic art. And these expressions are on recycled skateboards. He's also done a ton of spray painting murals and street arts. And his canvas are also all over the world being shown. And they have been shown in San Francisco, New York, Mexico, Peru, Belgium, Paris, really all over Canada and the U.S. And other than his fine art, Chris also has served as the director of California's Creation Skateboards, doing graphic for them and really graphics for many skateboard companies. And you can also see his work. You've seen it before. I know you have, on CD covers, T-shirts, designs, magazine illustrations, advertisements, and really Chris's art is a reflection of his personal spiritual journey, and he really is one of those out-of-the-box thinkers, really someone who wants to break the box completely, and he is very optimistic and positive and really an inspiring person, and he also has been featured in magazines, and he has a full movie of his life online, Chris Dyer's Positive Creations. You should watch it. And he also has a coffee table book out by Schiffer Publishing. So a lot going on there. I'm really excited. Let's please welcome Chris to the show. Hi, Chris.
Hey, Dr. Kelly. Thanks for having me over.
Thanks for coming on. I want to start with you kind of growing up. I want to start with getting some background. And for those of us who've seen the Positive Creations documentary, I was kind of amused at how you were such a troublemaker and really, I guess I would almost call it like an instigator growing up. And you talk in the movie about how you were destructive and wild as a kid. And yet you know, now you seem so zen and so chill. What changed?
Well, you know, I think it's when you're a kid, the world sort of like screws with you. So you want to screw back to the world and stuff. And I still am a little bit of an instigator. I still like to, you know, screw with a situation if I find things are a little bit weird, but, you know, without being aggressive now or trying not to hurt anybody's feelings. But when you're a kid, you're a kid. So you just let your energy free and wild if possible.
Yeah. Yes. I mean, I feel you on that. I'm an instigator too. I get called an instigator. but you know, it's interesting how we find balance, right? How people can have kind of this, all these different traits, good and bad or good and evil. We talk about a lot. Do you think that, and this is just a metaphysical question, do you think humans are inherently good?
Yeah. Well, you know, many esoteric books and religious and all that stuff say that we're a reflection of God, the creator, and the creating force is a positive force. It's a force of love. So, yeah, I do have tons of faith in our human race and that we're good people who can pull it together. I think most people are inside, but when we turn to the other side, it's mostly out of, I don't know, just we've been hurt or traumatized or that we're finding a way to cope with the pain. And it seems sometimes comfortable to just choose destructiveness for that. And I myself have gone down that path. And it is fun. It is, you know, that's why negativity is so popular in the world. But I think at the end of the day, when we cleanse out all that BS and we find, we go back to creativity and love, we find that true happiness is there. And that's a bigger one. That's why I've chosen that path and I keep on feeding it.
That's what I was going to ask you. Even in spite of all of the kind of tumultuousness and the rowdiness of growing up, one thing that seemed consistent in the videos of you and people's reports is you always had that sketch pad. You're always drawing art. And is art what has kind of kept you grounded and has kind of helped you move from the destructive to the creative side?
Yeah, I would say art was always a healing tool. I was just born an artist. That was nothing that like I chose one day, like, hey, I want to be an artist. It was just something that I always had to do, and I always did it, and I always got positive reinforcement from my parents, from my peers. So, you know, when people make you feel good about something, you keep on doing it, and you get better, and it keeps on growing. But art is definitely a tool where I could sort of like draw at least what I was going through. And then through observing it from the outside, because it's not in the inside anymore, you start saying like, oh, so that's what I'm up to. Huh? And then mm-hmm. you reflect on it and then you keep on making your choices depending on those insights.
Mm-hmm. Like in psychology, I guess we would call that like, I don't know, externalization or something that yeah. you purge it. You know, it's the same for me. I am like, well, you saw, I tried really hard to make my Photoshop flyer, which came out good in the end. But I mean, it took me like a day to make a flyer on Photoshop. Like I'm not an artist, but I'm a writer and writing is my art. And so when I feel like crap and when I don't know what's going on and I get down and, you know, we, none of us, people think, oh, Dr. Kelly, you're always so positive. And I'm like, well, yeah, but, you know, social media and my work life doesn't see the full range of spectrums that I go through. I go through darkness, too, and I struggle sometimes. And when I go through that, what really helps me pull myself out of it is writing in my journal. Just get it out. Like, write all that nasty crap that you want to say, but you know you shouldn't say. Just put it all in the journal and get it out of you. And it's amazing how free and clear you feel after doing that. So
yeah, totally. I find that, you know, I obviously focus a lot on positivity, but that doesn't mean I'm 100% positive. I can be a jerk on a bad day too. And I definitely have my very sad days or weeks or months sometimes. And it's the positivity that's like a, you know, a lifesaver for me to hold on to and not drown down sometimes. And mm-hmm. it's the art that also, you know, it doesn't always have to be positive. If I do something that maybe is negative looking, it's because I want to reflect that negative side of me, observe it, deal with it, and as you said, purge it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, and one thing I really like about your art, it's weird. It's just so like, it's so trippy. And what did you always have that as your, like, what is your signature style? Is that something that evolved like when you were studying art later on in your life? Or did you kind of just always go for like these weird like colors and shapes and patterns?
Well, as a kid, you know, we always start by copying. So you copy a comic book, you copy a TV show, etc. But then what I realized eventually is that I'm not really being myself if I'm doing all these characters from the outside. So I try to always develop my own characters. And that would make me feel better. It's like, oh, damn, you know, like that's 100% you. That ain't came from nobody else. That's when you can truly be like, you know, a god, because you're creating your own universe. So definitely I do inspire from all the different cultures that I love. But if I can come and create my own culture, that's a bigger contribution I can do in the world of art or even, you know, for humanity. So for me, that's very fun. And I don't know when it started happening. It's just, you know, it just gradually happened throughout the years. And I don't know how to, you know, verbalize what a Chris Dyer style is, but I think you can just, you know, feel it out or observe it.
Yeah. So I guess one question, we have like a minute or so until we go into the break, and we'll pick this up after the break. Do you believe that everyone is an artist?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Because art is simply the way you do things. You know, your life is your art or your painting. You know, the music you choose, the way you prepare your food, the clothes you put on, everything is an art. Like, art is just your soul's expression and the outside. So, yeah, we're all artists.
I love that. I love thinking about it like that. So many creative people out there say they're not artists or they're not creative. And I used to be one of those people, you know, because I was like, I just write stuff. I'm not like creative. But actually, like, we have our creativity in so many areas. And the more that we nurture this, I think it can really have positive impacts on the flow of our life. So thank you for that. And we're going to go into the break right now. So you are listening to Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly. And when we come back in a couple minutes, Chris Dyer and I will talk more about his positive creation. So stay tuned and we'll be right back.
Yeah, yeah.
Introducing the Lucid Planet, a digital gathering place featuring cutting-edge, high-vibrational content that will empower and inspire you to become the greatest version of yourself. Visit the Lucid Planet today to stimulate your mind, body, and soul as you connect with a global community of like-minded people. The Lucid Planet is edited by renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly Neff, who is here to help you cope with anxiety, connect to your higher purpose, uncover your true passions, and live your dreams. Dr. Kelly's fresh, compassionate perspective emphasizes growth, transformation, healing, and thriving. Even in the face of adversity, say goodbye to bad news and low vibrational media for good and become part of the larger collective of people working together to navigate the global shift of consciousness and transform the world from within. Join the planet, the Lucid Planet. Visit thelucidplanet.com. Welcome home.
Are you ready for a game changer? Sarah Westall is bringing you Business Game Changers Radio. Sarah brings you leading experts, visionaries, and newsmakers who provide the best commentary on big issues and cutting-edge innovations. Sarah's 20 years as a business executive will help you think like an entrepreneur with expertise, energy, and attitude. Tune in to Business Game Changers Mondays at noon Pacific, 3 Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Hey everyone, meet my friends at the maca team. The ancient Inca root vegetable maca is known worldwide for its huge array of health benefits. As a family-run company of true maca specialists, the maca team is here to bring you the best maca the Peruvian mountains has to offer. Yellow maca, used to promote endurance, vitality, fertility, hormone health, and much more, is on sale now. I love it. Visit themacateam.com to order yours now. Themacateam.com.
Oh,
We are back on Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly, and my guest today is visionary artist Chris Dyer, and we are talking about spirituality, art, creativity, psychedelics, and really like the future of humanity. But before we continue, I just want to make sure, Chris, that our listeners know how to get in contact with you. Could you give them your info and tell them where they can find out more about your art, positive creations, your book, your workshops, festival appearances, etc.?
Oh, yeah, plugs. you can check out my webpage. I just spent the last year updating and making a brand new webpage that really is way easier to navigate than it used to be, positivecreations.ca, as in Canada. And and from there you can pull the thread. You can find my Facebooks and Instagrams and all that stuff. You can write me if you want. I try my best to answer because I'm pretty busy, but I'm always happy to hear from you guys.
Oh, right on. And, of course, you have your dope video series, too, on YouTube.
Buy my stuff. Go to my events. And you, like, give me money.
Give him money, okay, guys? Just, okay. Give it to him. Chris, you'll also be at Gem & Jam Festival in Tucson, right?
Yes, I will be there next week, and I'll be live painting on stage. I'll be doing a collabo with this artist called Aaron Brooks. Should be pretty fun. I'm really excited to go there because I'll finally go and see the Grand Canyon too.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, you got to check that out. You should go on the Sky Bridge thing. Do you know what that is?
No.
There's like this bridge that you can walk out on, and it's glass, and you just look down into the Grand Canyon.
That sounds terrifying.
Terrifyingly awesome. Yeah, no, it is. It is. Chris does a lot of festivals. He paints live a lot. I've seen him live at Envision and Symbiosis, and I'll be at Tucson for Gem & Jam as well, guys. So please, if you see either of us heady-dreadies, come and say what's up. I also just wanted to take a minute, another plug, just to announce, well, as we're talking about festivals, Lucid Planet and Lucid Planet Radio has a really exciting partnership with my favorite, really transformational event, Lucidity Festival, which is in April 8th to 10th in Live Oak, California. And one thing that I think is really amazing is that Lucidity is offering its first ever Lucid University course week. So it's not just about come to the festival for the weekend and rage, although I'm sure that's what a lot of people want to do, but it's come the week before, starting on Monday, and learn and enrich your life and grow. And these are really awesome 4-day intensive programs. There's one on permaculture design. There's one on lucid dreaming. There's one on Reiki healing. There's one on embodiment and leadership. And then there's one on the fabulous topic of art and creativity. And so I'm just putting this out there that this is a really awesome learning opportunity. And because it's new, they're offering $100 off when you buy your festival ticket and your Lucid University pass. And what's really cool is if you type in Lucid Planet, when you're buying a ticket to Lucid University or Lucidity Festival, they will give you $15 off. So bam, plug for a good cause, because I will definitely be there. I'll be seeing you in April outside of Santa Barbara. Amazing event. Okay, Chris, let's get back to talking, shall we? I'm sorry about that.
Yeah.
last week I had, well, you know what, before we talk about last week, before we went to the break, I asked you, you know, does everyone think they're an artist? Or is everyone an artist, even though not everyone thinks that they are? And what I'm wondering is, for the people out there who want to be creative, or they want to cultivate, you know, their art, or they want to make a living doing art, do you have any advice for them?
Well, first of all, if you want to make a living off your art, first of all, you got to do your art because of your passion. You know, don't do it because of like, oh, that'd be a fun career. You know, do whatever you love doing. And if you can milk it as a career, then you win double.
Yeah.
But don't come out of it as in like, oh, well, it'd be cool. It's got to come from the heart. So if the heart's in place and you're rocking out of passion, then the money will just come if you're just really following that passion. So that's pretty much, like, there's a lot of, like I teach workshops on, like, how to succeed at the career of art. I'm going to have one at COSM in May, so that's a plug right there.
And, the Church of Sacred Mirrors, Alex and Allison Gray's spot in New York.
Yeah, so I'll be there. It'll be a 3 to 4 day workshop, and in one of those days I'll focus on, like, a 2-hour speech. I'm like, okay, you want to make money from your art? This is what you do. But in a nutshell, it's just, if you're following your passion, then you're going to get it, you know, because nothing will stop you till you've, you know, reach what your heart is begging you to do.
Mm-hmm. So is this kind of part of your spiritual framework that you work under, that you can manifest really anything into your life so long as you have the intention and the drive behind it?
I don't know about anything, but once again, what you're meant to do. Like, I was always meant to be an artist, and I'm so passionate about it. Sometimes it hurts, so I just go for it full force, and it works for me, and I think it could work for anyone who really comes out of it in that direction too. It's just, there's a lot of hard work to, you know, it's not just going to be like, well, I really want it, and then you don't do anything. That doesn't work. You gotta go and get it, you know? You gotta crush everything.
Seriously, you gotta crush it. While also remaining true to yourself and not kind of like, I know the idea of quote selling out is a really big thing, that, you know, you can't sell out, but you need to make money. What do you do? You know,
that's a question to me. I don't know, like, what's the definition of selling out? I guess selling out would be like to sell your art to things that do not match your personal ethics. I think you can totally find the money while still doing what you think is right. And that's what I do. Like, if, like last week, McDonald's wanted to hire for something, and I'm like, I'm not working for McDonald's, but thank you very much. And I told them like the 20 reasons why I wouldn't do it. But
That actually happened?
Yeah.
Oh, no kidding.
And the person who wanted to hire me just laughed so much, because I actually, my first job ever was working at McDonald's at 17 years old when I arrived to Ottawa, and Noe would hire me. And I told her, like, why, like, I sucked at it and why I got fired by my cokehead boss and blah, blah, blah. And instead of being offended, she thought it was hilarious, but obviously she couldn't use it for her advertisement.
No. Yeah, okay, so that's what I would mean by selling out. Like, you let, like, some big corporation whose ethics you disagree with use your art because you want the money, but it's really simple, I guess, just don't do it.
Yeah, but I still will sell the shit out of my art, and I've got no guilt about it. Like, I want to live a comfortable life. Why that whole like thing of like, oh, the starving artist, or you're not pure if you're not broke? I do not believe in that whatsoever. I think artists should have as much money or more money than any other business boring job. Like, mm-hmm. you know, we contribute as more or as much or more than normal jobs. So why should we be kept down in a position of disempowerment? So mm-hmm. no, the more money I get, the more money I can use to enjoy life and empower my peers and make the world a better place to some degree.
Yeah, I completely agree. And a lot of this has to do with worthiness and knowing that you're worthy of it and your art is worthy of it. And I agree, too, that the stereotype of the starving artist has got to go. That doesn't serve us. I feel like that society created that so that we'd go work in like an office cubicle. But the reality is you can make a good living off your art, but you have to really grind and you have to put yourself out there. And I know when you got started, you worked on a lot of skateboards, and you still do, because it's products that a lot of people can buy, you know, and like flyers and CD covers and all these things. Like, you can always find ways to kind of branch out so that you're not just doing, say, like canvases. One thing I want to ask you, Chris, how is this going by so fast? We had a show last week with Graham St. John, who wrote A Cultural History of DMT, and we were talking a lot about psychedelics, art, and spirituality, and kind of the intersection of this. And I personally feel like your work really seems to capture this. Has there been a lot of importance in the use of psychedelics for your creative process and for your spiritual growth?
I would say no. I would not use psychedelics in order to find my artistic vision. I have used psychedelics in my personal growth of self-discovering and even healing, and that then reflects into my art. But I'm not going to be like, well, I got nothing to paint, so I'm going to do some acid and see what trippy stuff comes out. I think that's not the right intention to how to go about it. But then, like, last month I went to Peru to do ayahuasca, not to look for visions, but to heal my heart that was hurting, you know, to also actually cleanse out some, you know, addictions I had in myself. So yeah, I super honor psychedelics with the right intention at the right time, at the right dosages. But yeah, I wouldn't really say it's like, you know, something that I do in order to find my artistic vision.
Mm-hmm. I think what you're advocating is like the responsible use of these substances that are really medicinal to be used in like the proper way for the individual as opposed to like recreational.
It's fun too, but that's why we got our 20s, you know. I did like mushrooms for so long just for the fun of it, and I just really never got something till I just really sat down and used them with intention, and then it was just so much more powerful. And you know, this is like really like strong, important things that have been given to us, and we can't just like, you know, do it for the sake of having a good time only, you know? I don't know. I've matured throughout the years. And when it comes, now that I'm a role model and all these kids are listening to me, I can't just be like, yeah, let's go out there and do a ton of psychedelics, because I don't want to be responsible for anybody burning out their brains or doing it just to, you know, we really got to like be more conscious about anything we do, including the usages mm-hmm. of these really strong things that could improve us or, you know, not.
You know, we were talking about psilocybin. We know there's a lot of research suggesting it actually rebuilds your brain, right? But having said that, maybe that's why you're so smart. I got to interrupt you. We got to go to the break. I'm sorry. This is Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly. When we come back, Chris and I will continue more about this discussion of psychedelics, art, culture, spirituality, and the future. So stay tuned.
Introducing the Lucid Planet, a digital gathering place featuring cutting-edge, high-vibrational content that will empower and inspire you to become the greatest version of yourself. Visit the Lucid Planet today to stimulate your mind, body, and soul as you connect with a global community of like-minded people. The Lucid Planet is edited by renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly Neff, who is here to help you cope with anxiety, connect to your higher purpose, uncover your true passions, and live your dreams. Dr. Kelly's fresh, compassionate perspective emphasizes growth, transformation, healing, and thriving, even in the face of adversity. Say goodbye to bad news and low vibrational media for good and become part of the larger collective of people working together to navigate the global shift of consciousness and transform the world from within. Join the planet, the Lucid Planet. Visit thelucidplanet.com. Welcome home.
Are you ready for a game changer? Sarah Westall is bringing you Business Game Changers Radio. Sarah brings you leading experts, visionaries, and newsmakers who provide the best commentary on big issues and cutting-edge innovations. Sarah's 20 years as a business executive will help you think like an entrepreneur with expertise, energy, and attitude. Tune in to Business Game Changers Mondays at noon Pacific, 3 Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Hey everyone, meet my friends at the maca team. The ancient Inca root vegetable maca is known worldwide for its huge array of health benefits. As a family-run company of true maca specialists, the maca team is here to bring you the best maca the Peruvian mountains has to offer. Yellow maca, used to promote endurance, vitality, fertility, hormone health, and much more, is on sale now. I love it. Visit themacateam.com to order yours now. Themacateam.com.
Are you ready to start winning at the game of life? Lynn Brown, host of Get Into It, Winning at the Game of Life, is here to help you reach places and goals that you never thought possible. Lynn is an intuitive healer with a specialized background in financial healing. She combines her intuitive nature and her wholesome approach to financial planning. To learn more about her financial planning services, contact her personally at letterrintuit.com. Francine Vale is a being of light. She believes that all people of planet Earth are as well. As co-host of the Angel Healer radio show, Francine teaches you heart-centered ways to manifest healing on your own behalf and how to integrate love more fully into your daily life. Connect with your angels as you find your life flowing with ease and harmony. Walk the path of light with Francine and Dr. Pat Basile every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
We are back on Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly, and I am here with visionary artist Chris Dyer of Chris Dyer's Positive Creations, talking about life and art and creativity and spirituality. And when we left off from the break, we were having a pretty heated and festive conversation about psychedelics, and I just wanted to pick that up. You know, Chris, a lot of people that your art's a psychedelic, they assume that you probably eat a lot of psychedelics, but actually you don't really, do you?
Well, I have in the past, and I learned from the experiences, and then I moved on. You know, I feel like psychedelics has, you know, as I go in a class, but do you really want to go, like, you know, to fourth grade forever and never really move on forward? Yeah. And, you know, I find that, you know, if you can't really do trippy art without doing psychedelics, it's almost like there's a problem there, because it would be like saying, like, somebody couldn't run, you know, a marathon without doing speed, you know, like, or somebody couldn't fall in love without doing ecstasy. That's, you know, we can't, you know, of course we want to enhance certain experiences at some point, but we can't depend on it, you know, like everything's inside us already to rock. So
yeah,
it's trying to find that magic ourselves.
Yes. And rock out and then inspire other people too.
Yeah, totally.
We can turn anything into a drug, right?
Well, we're addicted. We always want to take it to the next step. I know I am, and that's why, you know, I got to deal with that sometimes.
Mm-hmm. But, I feel you. I'm an extremist, you know, and it can be tough, but it's about, I guess, like having a daily practice of staying grounded and focused can help a lot. I hear. No, I can. I have a question for you.
Yes.
You know, people talk a lot about you're a very spiritual person, and I guess I'm curious to hear from you, like, you know, what your perception is on kind of the difference between religion and spirituality. And the second part of that is, I'm wondering if you agree with Alex Gray's assertion that art is the greatest religion.
Okay, well, religion originally was a spiritual path, but then it got culturalized, you know, right? Today's religion is culture, you know, it's the culture from here, from there. It's got a clothing, it's got its songs, it's got its foods, it's got its traditions. And that's cool and beautiful, because culture really is expressions of the soul, but we can't let culture put us in a box and not break out, because that's the opposite of the spiritual growth we want to attain. So I guess spirituality would just be living from a point of spirit, and that doesn't have to be encased by one culture. It can be in touch with all cultures or none of them at all. Mm-hmm. And I think it's about, you know, just being a good person that lives out of love and tries to be the best possible. That's always the quest that we all try to attain, and it's so difficult, but I guess that it is in a nutshell. Mm-hmm. And for your second question, art is the biggest religion of them all. You know what? I would agree in my life, but we're all different. I'm an artist, so my main meditation would be to create and make art every day. But some people don't like to do paintings or don't like to do art in general. Some people just like to sit and watch TV. So, you know, I don't know.
But is it art on TV that they're watching?
Yeah, maybe. So, you know what? Maybe. Alex Gray's a genius. So I'm going to have to agree with him. I'm definitely part of his church. If his thing is true, the church, I'm one of his disciples.
Yeah, totally. The prophet, Alex Gray. I love it. I know that music plays a really important role in all of this for you, too. And I know you collect a lot of vinyl. I've seen your collection in one of your episodes of the Positive Creations Adventures. What is your favorite music to work to, and how does music influence your art?
Well, I love a wide variety of music. I'd say my favorite kind of music is progressive rock, because it's got that edge that I myself carry. And it also has imagination, and the narratives it speaks about are more like trippy. And so, I'd say progressive rock's my favorite kind of music in general. But I love like world music and reggae and rock, heavy metal, and I'm getting more and more into electronic now that I'm going to all these electronic festivals. And you know, they're all like, once again, expressions of the soul on so many flavors, and it's beautiful to see like how magical humans are and how it gets out vibrationally.
Absolutely.
And that inspires me too. Like, you know, if I really want to do a different kind of painting, I'll put on Miles Davis Bitches Brew and an empty canvas and see what happens, you know? And
nice.
And it definitely can inspire my mood and make things better. So, yeah, I love music.
Awesome. And something else that, you know, we know is you work across so many different mediums. What's your favorite? Do you have a favorite, or do you kind of go back and forth between like the spray painting and the paint, and, you know, how do you decide what medium you're going to use for a piece?
Well, it depends on the mood, you know, because like when it's winter, I can't spray paint outside, so I got to stay inside and do canvas. Yes. These canvases take months, and it drives me crazy a little bit, but it's a really deep meditation where I get to crystallize something really special. And then when it's summer, I'll spend one day on a wall, and then it's crushed, and maybe I'll get tagged over the next day. But it was fun just to like jam with my friends. Then sometimes I really need to do, a graphic for a brand or for myself, and that would just be ink. So it just changes depending on what I'm really trying to say. Last month I did a watercolor for a poster of an event, and just because it had like, it just had a more feminine feel. And it's like, well, you know, I want to go with watercolor since it's softer. So it just depends on what's the vibe.
Mm-hmm. I love that. It's must be great to be super dynamic like that too.
Well, I can't say I'm the best at every single medium. I feel there's a lot of work that I need to do on many mediums, but that's also good, because if I was good at everything, then that's boring, you know? Like,
oh yeah,
the challenge and the improvement that you see is part of the fun of the game.
Yeah, well, and like we were talking about before the show, it's not a competition, right? Yeah. There'll always be someone better, and that's a good thing.
Well, we'll always feel bad that, I don't do this technique like that person. But, you know, that's natural, and you just got to get over it and remind yourself that as long as you're having fun, that's all that matters.
Exactly, exactly. This is not necessarily about perfection. Although I was going to ask you, are you a perfectionist? Do you have a hard time letting go of a piece and like deciding it's done?
No, the piece is done, I know it. But I am a perfectionist in you know, many things, and people who work with me know that and suffer through that. And and that's okay, because why not? You know, you want to give it your all whenever, whatever you're doing, you want to try to make it as perfect as you can make it. So it's not a bad thing.
Oh, ring, ring.
Yeah,
no worries.
Allery, pick up the phone.
Do they want to call into the show?
It's for her.
Okay, Chris, one area, we only have a couple of minutes to the next break, but one area that you definitely seem to be pretty perfectionist is your dreadlocks. They are one of your distinguishing feature, and they're epic and huge. Mine are like really thin and little, and yours are like gigantic. And I just have to ask, are these related to your spirituality, or do you just like having dreads?
I've had dreads for 15 years, and I definitely didn't start them as a spiritual voyage. I didn't yet know anybody with dreadlocks when I got them, and I did them the wrong way.
That can be tough. Believe me, that can be tough.
Yeah, you know, beeswax, it was gross. But as I had them, it started attracting a different kind of people. Like, I wasn't a hippie when I got my dreadlocks, but then all these hippies started getting attracted to me. And then I get to meet them more and give them a chance and learn the good things they had to say to me. So yeah, I guess I got influenced majorly by that, and my hair did change my life. And you know, it's been my crown on my head for the last 15 years, and I don't really see any reason to cut them, so they keep on getting fatter and heavier and outwardly grayer.
Let's not talk about that part, because I know. You know, they are good though. If you're going gray, dreads kind of hide it a little better, I think. They kind of like distract people from it. It's all good, exactly. They must be like super heavy though. Like, does your neck hurt?
I just have evolved to have a thicker, stronger neck. So don't ever have somebody ask me to headbutt them.
Oh, nice. Oh, no. Yeah, definitely not. So moral of the story, guys, if you want to be around cool hippie people, just grow some dreads and magical things will happen and you'll be an artist and it'll be awesome. okay, on that note, we're going into the break. We'll be back with the final segment of our show featuring Chris Dyer, and we will see you in a few.
Just an old-fashioned love song playing on the radio, and wrapped around the music is the sound of someone promising they'll never go. You swear you've heard it before as it slowly rambles on. No need in bringing them back, cause they're never really gone. Just an old-fashioned love song.
Are you ready to start winning at the game of life? Lynn Brown, host of Get Into It, Winning at the Game of Life, is here to help you reach places and goals that you never thought possible. Lynn is an intuitive healer with a specialized background in financial healing. She combines her intuitive nature and her wholesome approach to financial planning. To learn more about her financial planning services, contact her personally at letterrintuit.com. Francine Vale is a being of light. She believes that all people of planet Earth are as well. As co-host of the Angel Healer radio show, Francine teaches you heart-centered ways to manifest healing on your own behalf and how to integrate love more fully into your daily life. Connect with your angels as you find your life flowing with ease and harmony. Walk the path of light with Francine and Dr. Pat Basile every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
What if we really didn't have to die to go to heaven? Are you curious about the afterlife or rebirth? The highly anticipated new book from author Dr. Susan Allison, You Don't Have to Die to Go to Heaven, is available now. Find out how to find guidance and healing in the spirit realms. Order the book today and put it on your must-read list for 2016. Visit drsusanallison.com to learn more.
Introducing the Lucid Planet, a digital gathering place featuring cutting-edge, high-vibrational content that will empower and inspire you to become the greatest version of yourself. Visit the Lucid Planet today to stimulate your mind, body, and soul as you connect with a global community of like-minded people. The Lucid Planet is edited by renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly Neff, who is here to help you cope with anxiety, connect to your higher purpose, uncover your true passions, and live your dreams. Dr. Kelly's fresh, compassionate perspective emphasizes growth, transformation, healing, and thriving, even in the face of adversity. Say goodbye to bad news and low vibrational media for good and become part of the larger collective of people working together to navigate the global shift of consciousness and transform the world from within. Join the planet, the Lucid Planet. Visit thelucidplanet.com. Welcome home.
On the cutting edge of the new mainstream, Christine Upchurch is passionate about bringing together science, psychology, and spirituality in a way that can be applied to our everyday lives for true transformation. The Christine Upchurch Show, stellar conversations to illuminate your journey, engages some of the most outstanding visionaries on the planet in lively dialogue to inspire you to become that bright light you're meant to be. Join Christine every Friday at 11 a.m. Pacific Time on KKNW, AM 1150, and Transformation Talk Radio.
WPLQ.
love that song. Welcome back to Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly. I'm here with Chris Dyer, and we're rocking out, and we're talking about spirituality, creativity, and the future. And Chris, I've heard you say a lot of really wise things about kind of the evolution of humanity and where we're heading, and I would love to know what your thoughts are on that right now.
Well, you know, I don't really know what's going to happen. I know what I'd like to see happening, and I like to have hope and optimism that we're going to, you know, pull through. And I think that's possible. I think we're not going to pull through if we don't believe we can't. If we think we're just too much of a loser of a race that we're going to blow it no matter what, then let's just have a blast and like stay sleeping and just die, you know? But and that doesn't matter neither, because we're eternal souls that are just going through this virtual reality game. But amen. I don't like people suffering, you know, and people are suffering already. The world destroyed or not, that doesn't really matter as long as anybody is suffering on this planet. And there's plenty of people suffering. I don't like that. And I can't change that, and not one person can, but all together, if we all take different tasks and do something to alleviate the suffering of any creature on this planet, then we're already saving the world. Even if it all blows up at the end of the game, it doesn't matter, because at least we alleviated the pain of people or animals while it was still here. Mm-hmm. And I think that's super important. And that's one of the reasons I do art, to make some people happy. And, you know, I can't be out there in the streets, you know, protesting and being an activist anymore. But at least I can, you know, maybe inspire some people, some kids, to know that they can also be artists and follow their dreams. If that's my mission, that's awesome. You know, that's, as long as people are happy, I think that's
important. How do you stay positive in light of, I mean, this is, I guess, we're talking psychology. Like, what does it mean to be well-adjusted in such a messed up world? Like, how do you stay positive in light of all the hardships and the suffering? And it does seem like our media is kind of like pumping us full of news, like the mainstream media, of how terrible everything is, that it's getting worse. And how do you keep that positive energy going?
Well, it's difficult sometimes. You know, it's natural that we're all going to get bummed out when a lot of people are dying for stupid reasons. You know, because we're loving human beings. We don't want anybody to suffer. So that's beautiful that we suffer when we see the suffering of others. That shows how great we really are. But we can't stay in that state, because we're just going to keep on attracting more of that suffering onto our own lives. You know, we're going to just keep on vibrating that. And that's what, I guess, the powers that be, or the negative side, they want us to keep on thinking that way and manifesting in that way. So
the dark side of the force.
Yeah, exactly. So we just got to try to be the best Jedis we can be in our own lifetime, and, you know, create other Jedis if that's your goal, to have a family and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. Just try to do your contribution. Just ask yourself, like, what am I doing to make this world a better place? If you're doing nothing, fine. A little something, and then that's all good, you know? Don't feel guilty that you're not doing it all, or that you can't save the whales or whatever. You know, just do your part, you know, recycle something. So
it starts small, and then it becomes a, you know, that little pebble rolling down the hill becomes a boulder.
Exactly. Right? Because when you do it, then others see you, they get inspired to do it. And right there, you already did so much more than you thought you could do, because it's multiplying. And I think it's still multiplying. Yeah. And I'm still hopeful and optimistic that we can pull this out. It really doesn't take that much, you know?
You know, Chris, I love it. I'm an optimist. And it seems like every single person that I've had on my show just about is also an optimist and believes that we can fix it. And like, I believe, like, if I'm here doing this, putting these messages out here, if I came back into this time and space, into this flesh suit that I'm wearing until I return it, it's because, like, there is a chance that it can get better, that I can actually do something, and all of us can do something. And I won't let that go. Like, I really do believe that if we make the small changes in our lives, it can rebound and it can ripple out and it can have huge repercussions to everyone. But we actually do have to put the work in.
Funk, yeah.
Yeah, funk, yeah. you said that, I know you talked in your documentary very briefly about how you felt like you came back into this incarnation, like you were angry, like you were frustrated, like you were being punished. So do you believe in past lives? Do you still believe that you're being punished?
No, I don't know if I'm being punished, but maybe it's just something happened that I was just frustrated that I had to come back again to this crazy world. But, you know, we create our own destiny, and I've dealt with my own issues to some degree. And whenever things are not right, I go and find a way to make them right, you know, to deal with my issues and make it the best possible. And, you know, I accept sadness and I accept suffering. That's part of the human condition, and I learn from it and I use it to grow further if possible. So yeah, I don't try to, you know, curse it or anything. It is what it is.
It sounds almost Buddhist. Almost. I guess my last question, something I wanted to ask you earlier that I didn't get a chance to ask you, was you've worked and collaborated with a lot of really talented people. And I was just curious, kind of like, who were some of your favorite collaborations and what you learned from those? And this will probably be my last question.
You mean artistically or?
Yeah. Oh, in any way. Yeah. I was thinking in terms of making art, but there's probably other ways too.
Well, I like collabos with friends. You know, I've painted paintings with, you know, Randall Roberts and Amanda Sage and different people who have great talents. When you put two different talented people to do one painting, the painting's just even more crazy that one could do, you know, the sum of the, you know, I'm bad at math, so that I'm not very good at that saying. But basically, I like when I'm good at something and I put it out there, and if somebody can grab that and make it even better, like if I give my art to an animator and make an animation of my art, like that's awesome. So yeah, I love collaborations. That's something that will make this world a better place when we all unite and become better.
Absolutely. Well, and it you have to be respectful of other people too when you're collaborating on that level, and learn to kind of bend and be flexible and allow that, you know, that there really is something to be said for when we come together. And I've seen some of my favorite artwork, music, whatever, it's from people who maybe haven't worked together before and they've come together to make something really special. And I think that's great.
I think an important part of collaborating is simply letting go of your ego and letting somebody else take your painting in a direction you didn't want to. And, you know, and just trust that it's for the better.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes that's difficult.
I think that's good advice for life as well. Let go of your ego and just have trust. Chris, do you have any closing thoughts for us? Maybe perhaps you could let us know about the meaning of life.
Don't worry, be happy.
Oh, I love that. That's awesome. Well, you know, I think, you know, your art has definitely made a lot of people happy. And if that has been your mission, you've done a really good job. Because
I'm happy to be of service. That's why I'm here.
For sure. And I'm sure one of these days I will be able to pick up one of your original paintings. Or maybe we'll have to talk about that sometime when we're not there. Because I would love a piece for my studio. All right. Well, I guess on that note, it's time to wrap up the show. So, Chris, thank you so much for coming on.
And okay, thanks. I'm going to my driving class now.
Yes, you crush that driver's license. You do it. I really want to thank, bye Chris, I want to thank all the listeners as well for tuning in to Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly. I had such a wonderful time, and I hope that you will continue to join me every Wednesday at 5 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Central, 3 p.m. Mountain, and 2 p.m. Pacific on KKNW 1150 Seattle, WBLQ 1230, broadcasting from Rhode Island, Connecticut, and New York, Transformation Talk Radio, and soon on the CRN Digital Network. So you can find me at thelucidplanet.com and also connect with me on Facebook and Twitter at The Lucid Planet with Dr. Kelly. You can also listen to the archives of all of my past shows on SoundCloud at The Lucid Planet Dr. Kelly, and you can subscribe for free on iTunes to all the podcasts by typing in Lucid Planet, I think, or Dr. Kelly. Lucid Planet Radio. That'll get you. So we have come out the gate really swinging for 2016, heavy hitters. And next week we have Prince EA on the show. If you haven't heard of him, you might be living under a rock, because he has been blowing up the internet with his amazing videos and inspirational messages of awakening and unity. He's literally getting tens and tens of millions of views on YouTube. So don't miss next week's show. Same time, same place. Light and love, and I will see you next week. Take care. Bye.
You've been listening to the hit show
Lucid Planet Radio with renowned psychologist and author, Dr. Kelly Neff. Tune in each week as we illuminate your senses and empower you beyond your daily stressors and hardships. This hit show will captivate you with far-reaching topics and amazing guests as you wake up to the greatest version of yourself. Learn how to navigate the global shift of consciousness as you explore the deeper knowledge, passion, and purpose within. Visit lucidplanetradio.com for upcoming show topics and to contact Dr. Kelly.